Live 26. अब एंटरटेनमेंट कभी भी कहीं भी.
Mr. Biyani, we're going to begin with you. As a thought leader for Indian retail, how is the sports category emerging in India, in your opinion? Is it becoming a mega trend?
I think we have all grown with some sports, whether it was a gilli danda to a kabaddi to cricket to football to badminton. I think sport has been an integral part of our growing up scene. I believe it's a big part of everybody's life now, and it's turning into quite a lot of commercial activities around sports. There is a lot of business being built around sports, whether it's clothing, whether it's footwear, whether it's television, whether it's advertising, and there are celebrities, stars getting created out of sports in a big way. I believe it's becoming a big business also. So sports is taking a new turn, and I believe it's going to grow.
Anil, we'll go to you now. You've been in sport and the business of sport as well. Cricket will always be religion in our country, the greatest passion, but there are lots of other sports that have garnered a lot of interest, be it football, kabaddi, like Mr. Biyani just said, or tennis, badminton. So what are your thoughts on that as India, as a sporting nation?
I think, just to add to what Mr. Biyani mentioned, it's not just about cricket anymore. There are other sporting activities that are there. We are growing as a sporting nation, been performing at the international level across sports. We can see that men, women, we have icons now to look up to in different sporting categories. And the awareness about sport itself is good to have. And, it's not just about watching sport, but now people want to participate as well. You see a lot of people getting into running. You see a lot of running events, cycling, even walking. I mean, you see that quite a bit, not just, watching or following a sport. So I think as a nation, we are a young nation. So I think sport in modern world, getting out of your rooms and getting out of your offices is not easy with all handheld devices. So I think I'm glad that, sport is becoming a part of our culture, and it needs to improve. I mean, it's not enough. Sport needs to come into schools, and that's happening slowly. But, I'm really glad to be associated with DeFi because, like I mentioned, it's also about, the quality that needs to be used as well. So if you want to grow, it's important that you have the quality that comes about, and that's what you see currently happening in India.
Farhan, we'd like your perspective as well. You were amazing in Bhag Milkha Bhag. You portrayed the role of Milkha Singh. Do you think that we'll see sports in cinema and cinema on sports? Is it emerging as a trend, in your opinion?
Well, we are looking towards sporting icons, towards legends over time that we've had to bring their stories on the screen. There is a lot, I think, for children especially to learn about character, to learn about life, to learn about dealing with failure, to learn about how to reinvent yourself.
Motivate yourself, inspire.
Absolutely, to motivate yourself. And I find stories that if you can take them from sport, they are easier for people to understand because they're not very complicated. So for children to understand, sport plays a very, very important part. And as far as cinema in sport goes, I think nothing can be more dramatic than certain events that play out. When you're watching a sporting event, we've in our lifetimes, seen, be it in cricket, be it in football, be it in badminton, we've seen events play out where you feel that, this has played out in a way that it could not even be scripted. That if you wrote it, people would be, aisa kaise ho sakta hai? So that's also happened. So there is a lot of drama in sport. That's what makes it so enjoyable to watch. Heroes emerge, stories are created in a way that you just cannot possibly imagine. So there is a lot of drama. And as far as sport in cinema goes, I feel that for a young generation of India, like Anil rightly mentioned, we are a very young country. For that young generation, there's a lot of life lessons to be learned from watching their sporting icons.
Thank you, Farhan. I'm going to come to you, Mayank. Being at the forefront of digital technology and online retail, how does Amazon view India as a sporty, sporting, sport-loving nation?
Yeah, I think when we look at fashion as an overall category, we clearly see sports emerging as one of the largest categories within fashion. And I think it takes a lot of things to come together. Investment in sports infrastructure, investment in local tournaments, accessibility to sporting goods. And I think having brands like DeFi, which are making good quality sporting products more accessible, partnering with them, platforms like us, which are able to reach tier two, tier three towns, we think India is at a cusp of emerging sporting as a day-to-day culture. I see it around me and my colleagues, everyone is into some kind of sports. I see it at my son in school. At 6.5, he is into far more sports than I was till high school. So I do think India is emerging, and we see the results in many of the international tournaments now. One is going on right now, and we are doing well. So we think India is emerging as a sporting nation, and we think we would love to partner with all the people here and DeFi to be part of that journey.
Thank you. Ritesh, before I ask you why you invested in or are so invested in DeFi, are you into any sport? Are you interested in sport? And what was your sort of motivation to come on board with DeFi? Because Prashant talked about you right up top, saying it's so nice to have Ritesh and Farhan being a part of this journey with us.
Actually, I do. I begin my day with a sport. And I do kickboxing and I do some form of training. But I think that's the only time, which I was telling them earlier down, so it's like your me time, when you're completely cut off from your phone or any other digital attraction at that point. So I think playing some amount of sport, I think, determines how my day is going to go. So if I have a bad day, trust me, I haven't worked out that day. That's the thing. But I think coming back to investing, I think both Prashant and Rajiv, I met them at the office one evening when they were sitting with the marketing team. Actually, it was just by coincidence I bumped into them and I heard them about what they believe. So I think more than investing in the brand, I was more keen, both Farhan and me, in investing in them. Because I think they were so passionate about what they wanted to do. And they told me what they did the last 18 months almost of, you know, being in China, where they could have had the easier route, where most people go to China, just take a ready-made dye and put their brand on it. And they told me how they wanted to actually, make sure that they build a shoe which is, I think runners, because they both run, would have less chances of having some injury. And right from the sole to the designing. So I think their passion behind what they were wanting to create made me invest in them.
Thank you, Ritesh. Anil, I'm going to ask you the same. What made you come on board with DeFi? What was it that you saw? What was the potential that you saw in DeFi? Because you got on board and invested in the earlier stages, yes?
I think we all saw how passionate and emotionally involved Prashant is into DeFi.
Come on, big round of applause for all that passion.
And I've known Rajiv for a while, so it's not just about the brand itself, but I think, like I mentioned, sport, not just as sport, but also as a lifestyle, is something that the youth look for. I mean, it's not just about comfort, the importance of wearing a good footwear. It's not just about the T-shirt or whatever you're wearing, but also how it looks, I think, matters to the current youth as well. So all of that is available at DeFi, and the affordability as well. I think, that's the challenge. When you're playing a sport, it's important to use the right attire, right apparel, right shoes for you to play the sport, because otherwise you'll pick up injuries. You may pick up, difficult injuries that can probably be, it may take you out of your sport itself. So it's important that you consider all of that when you're going out to a store and picking up. And DeFi, addresses all those issues. And the best part is the affordability itself. And that's something that I wanted to look at. You have aspirational brands, but at the same time, you also want affordable brands. And that's what DeFi is. And I'm really glad to be a part of this.
We'll stick with you with the pricing for just a little bit. How important is good pricing for a sports person who's just, getting into sport? Of course, for a sports person, sports gear is very important, but how important is pricing to begin with?
No, I think it's extremely critical. You know, it's not that everybody can afford, and you know, parents can only afford certain amounts for sport. And at the end of it, you know, if you